Okay, today we're going to do buffalo wings. First off, you got to go to the store, see yourself some buffalo wings. Now, these are chicken wings, not from buffaloes, a bit smaller. Chickens have wings, even though they don't fly. So the first thing you got to do is separate the drumette from the wingette. Or what you can do is go to the store and do it the easy way and just buy the drumette already done, like that. And then you're left with the wingette and the that'll add a little bit there, but you just slice it off. There's your wingette. This little beast here, just chuck it away. Not suitable for man, beast, or other. Some people do give it to you. There's not really much meat on this. You're just wasting your time. So you just go about doing that. Get enough. Sure you get enough of all those people that are coming to your party, whether you're watching a football game, baseball, hockey, whatever. You know, people love wings, but beware, they drink a lot of beer when you're doing the wings. So if you're having fellas over, tell them to BYO, because they're going to clean you out of wings and they're going to clean you out of beer. So this is the first step in prepping it. Now you can do, when you're cooking your wings, you can do it a number of different ways. You could boil them in water if you want to. It takes out some of the flavor. You can roast them. So if you do that, first you would do is put some seasoning on them. Same thing with barbecue. You could barbecue them also. And the most popular way is frying. Of course, that is the most unhealthiest way, but it is the most popular and the most tastiest way. So that's one the way we're going to do it tonight. We're going to deep fry it in a little deep fry machine behind me. So we'll just keep on cutting them up. Almost done here. So this was about one and a bit kilos of wings. Probably to feed about 4 to 5 people. Okay. And then also, if you get them good and healthy sizes, you can use other pieces of chicken, but it's not as nice as the wings because it is a sort of a snack type food. Okay, that's all done. Now we're going to go to stage 2. Okay, so now we've got to go into stage 2, which is breading or seasoning your chicken. First off, all your things that you've just used, put them in the sink, get them out of here, keep everything nice and steady, because chicken is not the one thing you want to mess around with, because it naturally has something else. That's why you got to cook it properly, keep your hands clean, wash up, keep your surfaces clean. Okay. Good idea to do that. Now, what we're going to do today, we're going to use a premix. This is the Hooters premix. But if you don't have that or want to save a little bit of money, just a little bit of regular flour, some cornmeal if you want a little bit crunchy, but corn flour is also very good to mix with your regular flour. And maybe a little paprika, salt, pepper. If you want to get a little bit spicier, add some crushed pepper flakes. Keep it simple, nothing too much. It's just enough to coat the chicken. So in goes your chicken, toss it around. So as we put the chicken in through here, just make sure it's patted down a bit as you're going through it. Get a good coating onto it. You don't need to, like if you're doing like fried chicken where you would put it into a little bit of buttermilk or anything like that. For this type of chicken, you don't have to do that. You can if you like. Probably give it a little bit thicker coating. Okay, take off the plastic wrap. So over to the fryer. Get yourself a little set of extra fingers. Get your chicken. Okay, and put it into your fryer. If you don't have a fryer at home, the thing to do is use a good heavy skillet, and you don't have to worry about the temperature. This one here sets it at about 190. You get a little piece of bread, cut it up, and if it sizzles up, you know the temperature is just about ready. Also, the oil would have a bit of a sheen to it as it gets hot, and that's when you know it's ready. But you pick it up one at a time, okay, and place it in slowly so it doesn't catch the bottom of the basket. And just let it loose, just like you're doing fish and chips. And there we go, and we'll let that cook. And that's going to take about 15 minutes to cook. So you can put the top on it or just let it cook away. And they're happy in there, and we'll be singing pretty soon. Chicken is done. Well, I just let it drain for a minute or two. Just get the excess off, and I'm going to throw it into a nice little dish. Okay. So now they're in a deep dish there. Ready to be coated. So, use our favorite, and as you see we use a lot of it. We can do it by the gallon, okay? It's the most economical way. You're going to do wings every so often. we use wing time, and this one is the medium. Usually go for the super hot. So simply just pour some wing sauce over, just like that. Simple so far. Fix yourself the top, put it on there, and give it the old shake. And that gives you a good coating. Take a peek, see if you're all done. Yes, look at that. Perfect. Now for presentation, it's always nice to serve a little bit of lettuce or whatever. But again, if you got the fellas over and just watching a ball game, they don't care. So, just put on there, it looks really good. There you go. Look at these. Look how simple that was, right? All done. No fuss. No bother. Real easy. Perfect. There you go. Only thing I need is just a little bit of blue cheese or ranch dressing on the side. Put it on a little cup. Maybe if you want to get a little bit fancy, some celery sticks, carrot sticks. A bit healthy. Goes with the beer. Done. You beauty. Enjoy. Now these are good wings.